Okay, to start this look, we're going to prime our lid. I'm using Sephora's lid primer. I tried to zoom in, but the camera wouldn't focus. So we're just going to put this on the lid and along the lower lash line. And everybody should really be using a primer. If you're taking the time to do your eyeshadow, you want to make it look its best, and a primer will definitely help you achieve that. Sephora's eyeshadow primer is really affordable compared to all the other primers that are out there on the market. So just blend that out. Make sure you blend it in good along the lower lash line. Now I'm going to do my eyebrows. So I just have an eyebrow brush and I brush them into place. I'm taking Rimmel's eyebrow pencil and I just did a line along my lower eyebrow, line along my upper eyebrow, and then I'm just going to fill in the tail end of the eyebrow. And then now I'm going to take a dense angled brush by Sonia Kashuk. It's a clean brush, and just use that to, kind of pull the color into the eyebrows and blend it in. Now I'm taking NYX's Jumbo Eyeshadow Pencil in dark brown, and I'm just going to line along my upper lash line. I'm not going to go all the way into the inner tear duct area, so just leave that area open. And then doing a little bit of a cat eye. And I don't want to go over the ball of my eye either. Now I'm taking a pointed crease brush. This one is from Coastal Scents. Just using that to blend out the color. Make sure you keep it low to the lash line. And then once I get out to that cat eye part, I am taking it and dragging it, as far as it will go into my crease. Now I'm taking NYX's Smokey Eye Palette and a crease brush in this dark brown that I've pointed out. Tap off the excess and I'm going to lightly work that into the crease. And then also putting a little bit along the upper lash line. And then just working that back and forth in a windshield wiper motion. And we're going to have a couple of crease colors here. This is just to kind of warm that crease area up and just get a little bit of color down, but you want to do this light-handed. And I'm focusing right now on the outer crease, doing circular motions just to make sure that that Jumbo Eyeshadow Pencil is blended. Now I'm taking Maybelline's Quad and Chai Latte. Same crease brush with the color that I've pointed out there. It's a light taupe color. Tapping off the excess and working that into the crease. This will provide additional blending and just really tie the look in together. It has a great effect. So using a combination of circular motions and windshield wiper motions, also dragging that a little bit onto the upper lash line. Now I'm taking a flat brush with Fixed Plus, spraying a little bit of that onto the brush. We're going to go ahead and get NYX's pigment in Panic. And I got this pigment on cherryculture.com. Oh, I could not get the camera to focus there, but that's what the bottom of the container looks like. So we're going to get a little bit of that pigment from the cap. Just press that into the brush. And then tap off the excess. As you can see, a ton of fallout's happening, so we don't want that to fall out on our face. I'm going to go ahead and press that over the ball of my eyelid all the way into the inner tear duct area. That's why we wanted to keep that area without any of the dark brown. We want to keep it really light. So just pat that in. We're going to do some blending, so if it's a little messy, don't worry about it. Fixed Plus is also fairly reasonably priced. I got mine for $19. If you live in Canada, it would probably be more expensive, but if you have an extra 20 bucks, I'd say go ahead and get it and then start getting pigments. Back into that Chai Latte Quad, grabbing that light taupe color. We're going to use that to blend. And this continues to just tie all of the colors into the look. It really, you know, once you see at the end, it has a great effect. Now back with a pencil brush, and in this color brown that I've pointed out, tap off the excess, and we're going to run this along our lower lash line. So just try to connect it to the outer part of your upper lash line. I didn't do that initially, but I should have. Okay, now I have connected it. I should have done that from the beginning, but connect it at that outer lash, outer upper lash line, and then drag it along the lower lash line. Now I'm going back in with the flat shader brush, and I'm going to do the highlight, taking the color from the chai latte. Because the lid is so shimmery, you really want to go with a matte highlight color. And the Chai Latte Quad has a beautiful matte highlight color, so I thought I would just use that one. Now I'm taking Maybelline's, it's either a waterproof or a smudge-proof eyeliner, using that to line my upper waterline. And I'm also going to line my lower waterline, but I'm going to make an effort to connect the waterlines. That way the inner rims are lined all the way through and there's no gaps. Now I'm taking an angled eyeliner brush, and I'm going to grab a little bit of black eyeshadow, and I'm going to use that to set the waterline for my lower lash line. And this will just give the lower lash line eyeliner a little bit more staying power. Now I'm going to go ahead and curl my eyelashes and apply mascara. The mascara that I'm using is Prestige's My Biggest Lashes. If you follow me on Twitter, I tweeted about this mascara. I am madly, madly in love with it. It's crazy how long my eyelashes get. So just starting from the outer eyelashes and working my way inward. As you can see, I'm wiggling the wand at the base and then pulling up. This has an effect of coating, you know, the maximum amount of lashes.
Strong, hate to stare, but you're winning.